More than 1.5 million people have used this AI web design tool, and in this video, I'm going to show you why. Tools like Lovable are great, but they're not always able to perfectly capture your existing website and build onto it in the same branding and style. That's why I'm excited to show you Anima today, which allows you to perfectly clone your existing website and then use AI to vibe code and vibe design and improve and edit your site in the Anima editor. And in the second half of the video, I'm going to show you a really cool feature if you're getting started with a new website where you can have Anima get inspired by any existing website on the internet. Thank you to Anima for sponsoring this video, and you're going to want to see, especially in the first few minutes of this video, how good Anima is at perfectly cloning my existing site. Let's jump in. So here we are in Anima, and we're going to type a slash for a command, and I'm going to click the clone website option. Just type in conferencetap.com. This is a website that I own that I want to clone and work on inside of Anima. Now, there's also a Chrome extension that if you have any private website pages, you can get the extension and generate from a private page. But this is a public page, so I'm just going to enter the link. Then Anima is going to ask if I own the site, which I'm going to click yes, so that way it will actually clone it as opposed to using it as inspiration. So let's click continue. And now on the left side, we can see Anima is scanning our page elements. And here we can see we have 784 elements on this page, and it's going to scan all of them before building out the actual site. I really like the design of this editor. It makes me feel like the result is going to be really good. So we'll see what actually happens. Okay, this is crazy. So here we are in the preview, and literally Anima fully cloned my site, conferencetap.com. This literally looks exactly like it does on the actual website. So they must have actually gotten all of the elements, even the images are pulled in. That's why it asks if you own the site, because I own this site, it's okay. But you don't want to do this with a site that you don't own. But here we can see everything is here. And if we go to the code, we can see it literally coded up everything on the site. This is a page in Webflow. Like, this is built out in Webflow, but it took the site and totally wrote all of the code. And now we have all the code, which is really cool. So now we get to do the fun part of iterating on our design. So normally this is a site built in Webflow, so I can't vibe code in Webflow. Now it's brought over here, literally like pixel for pixel brought over into Anima. And we're going to iterate on the design. So we're going to use this feature, this select feature first to show you what's possible here in Anima. So you can select any element. I'm going to select this button and I'm going to say, can we make the button pop a bit more? And now Anima is going to make edits. It's going to tell us exactly what it's editing on the left side. So here we have the new button, and we can see it added that really nice hover and animation to this button. And you can compare it to our other button, which doesn't have any of that. So it did that on its own. And now let's say we really like that. I'll say, please apply the same styling to all buttons on the page. And just like that, now this button has the same animation. This one does as well. So it intelligently went through the entire site and it added those animations. Now we're going to start working with adding sections. So I'm going to say, can we add a testimonial section below the top header? And let's send that off. And I just want to highlight as well, up here you can download the code. I mentioned before about pushing to GitHub. You can download the code as well. So everything can be taken out of the platform. You're not locked into Anima. And then we can also publish when we're ready and click that button. And it's going to build and publish. And we'll see that in a second. It looks like it's publishing while it's building this code. So we'll see which one gets done first. But it's publishing the project, so then you will be able to host it and view it on its own URL. So here it added a testimonials page, what our customers say. What I'm really impressed about with this is that it used the same styling and fonts and everything, so it fits in really well with the rest of the site. It even has this background image that we use here with the blue. So it really fits in well with everything else. That's really cool that it was able to do that and understand the context of the site and put it all together. Now we're going to make a change to say, can you update the top header copy to improve it for conversions? So let's see if the AI just comes up with some better ideas than I already had for the top header of the site. Here's what it came up with: professional event app starting at just $1,995, enterprise level features without the enterprise price tag. I really like it, actually. I think this might be better than what I had. So just another use case here with Anima is taking your site and then having it come up with different copy examples. And then it's also nice to see what it looks like new copy on your actual site. So it's not just like working with ChatGPT. And then it also has the context of your entire site as it's making these copy changes. In a minute, I'm going to show you this flow feature that Anima has. But to do this, we're going to have to add another screen to our site. Because right now, it's just a one-page website. We didn't bring in other pages. Now, there's a couple ways to do this. One, you can upload a multi-screen flow using the Anima plugin in Figma. Or we can prompt to add new pages in our app. So I'm going to prompt, and we're going to see Anima add a page to our site here. So I'm going to say, let's add an about page that links from the navbar about button. Please do your best to create an awesome about page. So now we can test it out. Here we are on the homepage. I can click the about page. And it created this entire about page from scratch. And it matches my design style. This is the key here that I think is really impressive. I haven't seen this anywhere else, is that it's fully matching the design. It fits perfectly with the homepage that was already generated. And it's even taking the CTA from the homepage and putting it where it makes sense to. So I took some liberties with who built it, but of course that's easily changed by prompting or even going into the code. So now in the flow tab, we can see we have the logo and the desktop menu, which are both buttons that are in the component that are basically allowing us in the preview to go back and forth. So we can click on about, and then we can go back to the homepage by clicking on the logo. So that's cool. Just a way to visualize the flow in your app through Anima. And now lastly, let me just show you the publish feature in action. So if we go over and hover over publish, because we have published the site, oh, I can even publish it again just to make sure all of the latest features are in our URL. And you can now preview your site in a web browser to fully browse it and see what it looks like. And you can view it on different screen sizes, on mobile, however you want to see it. So this is a great way to click through your site and see what it looks like live. Now I'm going to show you how to use Anima, but by using an existing website as inspiration instead of as an actual clone. So we're going to do the same thing, and we'll do a slash command clone website. We're going to do apple.com this time, and we're going to import this site, but we're going to say we're using it as inspiration. And then we're going to replace the content with my own style. We're not going to say we own it because we don't. We don't own apple.com. So we're just going to use this as inspiration. We're going to hit continue, and then it's going to clone apple.com. But then we're going to use it to actually change the design fully for a new idea. Now what we're going to do is say, okay, take this design, and it perfectly cloned apple.com. It looks really nice. But I'm going to say, I want you to take the design style's inspiration and update it to not be apple.com, but instead be a conference app targeted towards event organizers. So let's see how Anima does taking that initial design that it created from apple.com, but transforming it here, as it says, into a modern conference app software site for event organizers. All right, so here's version one. And I can see it does have that Apple-inspired design. Like, the font looks similar. It has that really simple, minimalist style. I don't love the purple as much that it added here, but the buttons look really nice. This could be where we would add an image. We would add an image here. So, like, it's giving us basically empty sections to add images or screenshots, basically. But overall, it's nice. It's simple. It has that, like, modern feel. But let's have it change the color scheme. So let's say I don't love the purple pink color scheme, and we make it blue pastels instead. Okay, and this I like a lot better. I think this color scheme fits more like what I was looking for. Sometimes I find these AI design tools lean towards purple if you don't ask it for a different color. So just something to be aware of there. So again, like the previous one, we have access to all of the code. We can push it to GitHub, download the code, publish it, everything we have access to there. So yeah, this is looking really good. As a next step, we could add our images to this, but overall, really impressed with the first result here. And it does have that Apple look. And of course, you could do that with other websites as well to get inspired and bring some design inspiration into your site. So I hope that you enjoyed this. This is one of the coolest AI design tools that I've come across. I'm really glad that I was able to show this tool to you today. Let me know what you think in the comments. I'm really impressed with the quality of the design, how well it's able to maintain design styles throughout the entire website from our existing site that we were able to clone and bring in. So really cool that it was able to do that. Click the link in the description to get started with Anima for free. They have a free tier so you can try this out for yourself, and subscribe to our YouTube channel to get more free content like this. Thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.